Let me ask you an interesting question. Now, you must have seen that when you place a nail or any small iron object in water, it sinks immediately. But if you have ever gone to the seaside, you must have seen big ships, heavy ships, which float on water. Now, if it is common knowledge that a heavier object sinks in water, but a lighter object floats, why is it that this light pin is sinking, but this heavy object, this ship, is not sinking, but floating? To find out the answer, let us explain it on the basis of Archimedes' principle. But first, we are going to look at a very interesting video. In this video, you will find that plasticine dough is taken and molded into a flat-shaped structure. As you can see, over here, this plasticine dough is floating. Now observe what happens when the same plasticine dough, without any addition, is curled up to a ball and then it sinks. So as we could see, the same plasticine dough of same mass floated when its shape was flat, but sunk when it was curled up into a ball. Now, when we consider the flotation or sinking of any object, it is important to remember that any object in a fluid has two forces acting on it. There is the downward force, that is the weight of the object, and the upward force, that is the buoyant force due to the liquid. So let us find out in what case the object will sink and in what case the object will float. So when the buoyant force is greater than the weight of the object, or in other words, the upward force is greater than the downward force, the net force acting on the body is in the upward direction, and thus the body will float. The converse is also true. When buoyant force is less than the weight of the object will move downwards. Why? Because the net force in that case will be in the downward direction, and thus the object will sink. However, when the buoyant force is equal to the weight of the object, that is, the upward force and the downward force cancel one another out, the object will not move. It will remain suspended. So now let us see why a nail that is kept in water sinks. Firstly, we consider the weight of the nail. The weight of the nail is nothing but mass of the nail into acceleration due to gravity. Now we have seen that the density of any substance can be expressed as mass divided by volume. So if I rearrange this equation, I can write mass as density into volume. Thus, mass is being written as volume into density. So if I now replace this equation in this equation for weight, what will I get? I will get weight of the nail is equal to volume of the nail into density of nail into g, that is the acceleration due to gravity. Thus, I get the equation volume into density into g. Now, if I symbolize this equation, I can write it as v, which is the volume of the nail, rho n, that is the density of the nail, and g, which is the acceleration due to gravity. Now, I have found out the weight of the nail, that is the force acting in the downward direction. Now, I have to find out what the buoyant force or the force acting in the upward direction is. So, according to Archimedes' principle, the buoyant force on the nail will be equal to the weight of displaced water. That is, the amount of water that is displaced by the nail on submerging, the weight of that water will give me the buoyant force on the nail. So, how can I find out the weight of displaced water? The weight of displaced water is equal to the mass of displaced water into acceleration due to gravity. Even in this case, I can write the mass as volume of displaced water multiplied by the density of water that is displaced into g, that is acceleration due to gravity. So I write it as volume of displaced water into density into gravity. And now I will symbolize this equation. Now you might be asking me that what the volume of displaced water is. According to Archimedes' principle, the volume of the nail that is kept in, that volume will displace an amount of water that has equal volume. Thus, the volume of the nail and the volume of displaced water will be equal as given by Archimedes' principle. And we had taken the volume of the nail as V. So even in this case, the volume of displaced water will be V. So on symbolizing this, I get V into rho W, that is the density of water, into G, that is the acceleration due to gravity. So even in this case, I have obtained an expression for the buoyant force acting on the nail. So these are the two forces acting on the nail. The weight of the nail acting in downward direction and the buoyant force acting in the upward direction. Now, as you can see, in the expression for weight and in the expression for buoyant force, V and G are two common terms, so they are not influencing the magnitude in any way. What is influencing the magnitude? That's right. The density of nail and the density of water. So it is quite obvious that the density of nail, which is an iron object, will be much, much greater than the density of water, which is a liquid. Thus, we can say that since the density of nail is greater than the density of water, the magnitude of the weight of the nail will be much more than the magnitude of the buoyant force. So in other words, we can say that the net downward force will be much greater because the downward force is more than the upward force. So the net force is in the downward direction, and that is why the nail sinks. So the density of object immersed is more than density of fluid, and this is why the object is sinking in the fluid and not floating, because the weight is more than the buoyant force. So now let us come to the question of why a ship floats on water. A ship, as we know, is much heavier than a nail. So firstly, we consider a very interesting video. Over here, an experiment has been done with a toy ship. Now you will notice this ship, when placed in water, is displacing an amount of water whose volume is equal to the volume of ship that is submerged in water. Now this ship is placed in a physical balance. Once this ship has been placed in physical balance, what is done is, where the displaced water was collected, it is poured on the other side of the physical balance in two beakers. And you will see that the level of the physical balances becomes the same. So what does this mean? This means that the weight of water displaced is greater than or equal to the weight of the ship. If that physical balance would have been allowed to stay for a while, you would have seen that there would have been a minute difference in the two levels. So we can say that weight of water displaced is greater than or equal to the weight of the ship, because that difference would have been due to the fact that the water side would have been down, whereas the ship side would have been comparatively in the upward direction. So since the weight of water is greater than the weight of ship, that is the weight of water displaced, we can say that the buoyant force, which depends on the amount of water displaced, is greater than the weight of the ship. So what does this mean? This means that the net force that is acting on the ship is in the upward direction, because the downward force is less than the upward force. And it is due to this reason that the ship floats on water and it does not sink. Whereas on the other hand, we had found that nail sunk in water because the density of nail was greater than the density of water. Now in the case of ship, what happens is, most of the ship, despite the fact that its body is composed of metal, it contains air inside. Or in other words, the ship is hollow. So the density of the ship compared on a whole with that of water will be much less. And this is why we find the ship floats on water.